In a typical day, listening constantly, I suppose the things I'm most aware of are when I'm watching a TV show or listening to music or when I'm talking to somebody.
Listen to the television, sometimes listen to ambient sound all around.
There's a big distinction between listening and hearing. Hearing is something which is just passive. You hear lots of noises, conversations, things that you're not concentrating on. Listening is when you're actually actively concentrating on something.
Young learners need to develop the ability to concentrate for, you know, periods of time.
One would be kind of what I would call extensive listening or listening for gist, where they're not searching for any specific information. You just want them to get the meaning of what they're listening to.
They need to be able to listen for the keywords, especially when it comes to giving instructions.
The other one would be intensive listening skills, where they are searching for specific information.
It's good for young learners to be able to predict the content of what they're going to listen to, maybe by being told about characters in a story or being shown some pictures.
They need to know what to expect as well. When they're listening to something, they need to know what it is that they're doing. That's quite important. I think it's very useful for teachers to speak quite a lot with, especially younger children, but to make sure that the language is graded so that the children can understand.
The teacher can tell the students a little bit about what they're going to listen to try and develop some interest in the topic, to engage the students.
Give them a lot of practice in listening.
I teach mostly the younger children, so I like to make sure that they understand all the vocabulary in the task.
You could say that we're going to listen to a conversation about a certain subject. What do you think could be in the conversation? What do you think the people could be talking about?
We can ask students to predict the content before they listen, based on some limited information.
Do something like a board race, where I have the written words of the animals, I have the picture of the animal, and they have to go and hit the word and say what it is.
Identify the target language, like gap fill exercises.
While listening, they've got to look for specific information.
While they're listening, I always wander around the classroom to make sure that I know that they're all on task and they're understanding what they're doing.
Maybe they have to make notes on it.
Body actions or things like that when they hear a word.
I normally ask some questions about what it is that they've done, and then we might do something like a piece of writing, or they might draw a picture.
Try and get them to produce the Lexis in communicative activities.
An activity which is on the subject that the listening was on.
Engage the students first.
Making sure that the listening activity is at the right speed and that the language is graded according to the age and level.
Do listening activities very, very frequently. They really need them.
You know, try and get them on board, you know, wanting to listen.
Making sure that enough pre-tasks have been done before the listening.
Do lots of listening activities.